Hello and welcome to EG Math. We will solve question number 52 of OG Verbal Second Edition by using EG Math 3-step process. In the first step, we will understand the meaning of the sentence. In the second, we will evaluate the errors in the sentence. And finally, we will review all the answer choices to get to the correct answer. So let's begin. Recently discovered fossil remains strongly suggest that the Australian egg-laying mammals today are a branch of the main stem of mammalian evolution, rather than developing independently from a common ancestor of mammals more than 220 million years ago. Now, this sentence presents a contrast, and the phrase rather than is the marker of that contrast. The sentence says that some fossil remains have been recently discovered that strongly suggest that the present-day Australian egg-laying mammals are actually the branch of the main stem of mammalian evolution. These mammals have not developed independently from a common ancestor of mammals more than 220 million years ago. Now let us evaluate the errors in this sentence by splitting it into its clauses. So here comes the first clause. Recently discovered fossil remains strongly suggest. Here fossil remains is the subject and suggest is the verb. Presence of that brings us to another clause that reads that the Australian egg-laying mammals today are a branch of the main stem of mammalian evolution rather than developing independently from a common ancestor of mammals more than 220 million years ago. Here the Australian egg-laying mammals is the subject and are is the verb. Now, as discussed earlier in meaning analysis, marker rather than suggests that there is a list in this sentence. The Australian egg-laying mammals are X rather than Y, where X and Y should be logically and grammatically parallel. Well, logically they are parallel, but grammatically they are not. The phrase a branch of the main stem of mammalian evolution is entity X, which is a noun phrase because it begins with a branch. Now, the phrase developing independently from a common ancestor of mammals stands for Y and it is a verb ing phrase. Now, since entity X lies in the non-underlined portion of the sentence, entity Y needs to be turned into a noun phrase in order to do away with the parallelism issue. So we have parallelism error in this sentence. Well, this is the only error here, and let's find out which answer choice corrects this error. Well, choice A certainly does not, as we found out just now. Choice B is actually the correct answer, because now here X is a noun phrase as we had it earlier, and now Y has also become a noun phrase. It is a type that developed from a common ancestor of mammals. So both these entities are now absolutely grammatically parallel. So choice B is the correct answer. Well, let us evaluate choice C to find out why it is not correct. The phrase whose development was independent of distorts the meaning of the sentence. Well, this phrase now suggests that the development of the present day egg-laying mammals had nothing to do with the common ancestor mammals. Well, let's take an example here. When we say X grew independently from Y, we mean that X grew from Y, as in it evolved from Y, but independently. But if we say X grew independently of Y, it means that X had nothing to do with Y. X did not even evolve from Y, and this certainly is not the intended meaning of the sentence. So this choice is grammatically correct, but it certainly changes the intended meaning of the sentence and hence is incorrect. Let's take a look at choice D. Well, choice D repeats the same error as in choice A. Again, we have a verb ing phrase and a noun phrase which are not grammatically parallel to each other. In choice E, we again have the parallelism error. Well, a development is a noun phrase now, but it distorts the logical parallelism in the sentence. This choice implies that egg-laying mammals are rather a development. This is nonsensical because mammals cannot be development. So this makes choice E incorrect. So as we found out earlier, choice B is the correct answer for this sentence. Let's take a look at the takeaway messages now. In the sentences pertaining to parallelism, we must be able to identify the correct list, and we must make sure that all the entities before the marker and after the marker should be logically as well as grammatically parallel. Also, we must be wary of choices that distort the intended meaning of the sentence. The concepts tested in this sentence have been covered in EGMAT Concepts Level 1 Significance of Meaning, Level 1 Parallelism Identify and Correct, and Level 1 Parallelism Helpful Tips.